Hello, Jess.
Hello.
Hi. Tell me, how was your tour?
Like a dream. Much better, even than if I imagined the most perfect time. It's been even better. Bigger, better, happier, more dream fulfilling, amazing. There aren't enough words. Amazing.
So tell us, how was your tour day by day since the beginning, since you arrived to Egypt?
Well, since I started floating, since I started floating, from the moment that we got to the airport, we were nervous. It was the first time we'd ever traveled outside of the United States. There was a lot, but we were met by our driver, Gouda, who whisked us to his car and got us here safely. And I remember walking up the first time, coming up the elevator and coming in the door, and the wind, it was nighttime, and the wind was blowing through the curtains, and they were just billowing. And standing there in the moonlight, because the moon was almost full, just inside the doorway before I could see anything was Nurmen, and she was beautiful.
And then
I turned the corner. Oh, I'm gonna cry. It's been perfect. And the next day, we had a beautiful breakfast out here on the terrace. And we got to meet our tour guide, Saul, for the very first time. And he's the kindest, most welcoming eyes and smile. And we immediately felt at ease and comfortable, as he says. And Nurmen helped us get ready to go, and we went to Saqqara and Dahshur and Memphis, and it was all so breathtaking. And it was perfect to go there first, because you got the experience that I think most people, when they think about this, they think it's just this big desert and there's a camel and the pyramids, but it's different. But the bent pyramids and the black pyramid and the step pyramids are so, you can just be. And our tour guide was so informative. He knew everything. But he knew enough to not say everything. He let us explore, and he let us ask questions, and he gave us every piece of information that we needed. He went at our pace. He knew when we liked something to maybe point that out later, so that we could see the continuity of everything. So that first day was pretty monumental. The next day, oh, it was so exciting, because I could barely sleep because I knew we were gonna go there. And that was just awe-inspiring. It was everything that you could, just to stand there and take in how grand it was and how old and ancient and sacred. And we hear about these things when we're kids in school, and being there and experiencing it with a private tour guide, the ability to just be my husband and I, even though there's lots of people, our tour guide kind of insulated us a little bit and gave us the ability to be there and experience does it totally differently. They arranged for us to go horseback riding, which my husband was so surprised that that's his favorite thing of this whole trip. And he doesn't ride horses. Like, he rode a horse in Boy Scouts. And so doing that was, he was like a little boy. And riding through the desert, and they took great care of us. And then we took a rest day the day after. It's important to take rest days. And this is the perfect place to take a rest day because you can sit here and still experience all of that and rest because you're just so tired from all the emotions and traveling and all of that. Going to...
Then was Luxor.
Then was Luxor.
How was Luxor?